Welcome students, welcome to today's class. Last class we completed the chapter 2 and chapter 1 and 2 project time and all the book back exercises and question answers, everything we completed, right? So till that, if you are having any doubt, you can ask me. Chapter 1 and 2 completed everything including our project time programs, right? So we are going to enter into chapter 3. Still now, up to the completed syllabus, if you are having any doubt, please clarify it here itself. Without clarifying the doubts, without understanding the second lesson, we cannot enter into third lesson. So each and every chapter you want to understand, please read and understand. If you are having any doubt, please ask me. If you cannot understand the lessons, you cannot move further. Okay, please read all the chapters one by one and understand. If you are having any doubt, you can ask me. Now we are going to enter into the chapter 3, that is about decision making. Okay, decision making in PHP. How we are going to make decisions in PHP? What are all the statements we are using in decision making? We are going to see now. Okay, we can enter into the class now. Okay. So, first page in our chapter 3 is about the PEP activity. You all know, first every chapter, first will be dealing with the PEP activity. It is about the known information of yours, right? So, in this PEP activity 3.1, imagine that you and your 5-year-old brother are going to a theme park. Both of you like riding various joy rides. Some specific conditions to enjoy the rides include: roller coaster condition is only those who are over 10 years of age can take part in the ride. A ticket of rupees 50 should be bought. And in Ferris wheel, only those who are over 5 years of age can take part in the ride. The ride can be enjoyed by showing the ticket purchased at the main entrance. How will you decide which ride you want to try? So this is the condition to ride in the roller coaster and in Ferris wheel. So you and your 5-year-old brother, you two are going. So you want to decision, you want to make the decision in which ride you want to try. Okay. So you decide in which ride you and your brother will be going. Okay. So enjoy your rides. Your own answer, don't copy from your friends, write your own answer in this PEP activity. Okay, we'll go to second page. Yes, so about the PHP control statements, we are going to see what are all the control statements available in our PHP, for what we are going to use the control statements. So control statements are used to take the decision based on different conditions, like we saw in the PEP activity. According to the condition, below 10 years, below 5 years, like that, we are having conditions for riding in certain rides, right? So according to certain conditions, you want to take the decision. So control statements are used to take decision based on different conditions. Conditional statements are used in code to make the decision. So these conditional statements are used in code to make the decision. The next point, the control statements supported in PHP are, there are three control statements: if else, else if, and switch case statements. These three control statements are used in PHP program for making decisions. Okay. What are all those three statements? If else statement, else if statement, and switch case statement. These three statements are used in our PHP language for making the decisions according to certain conditions. Okay? Yes? Clear with this? What is meant by the control statement and what are all the control statements available in PHP? So what is meant by the control statement? Once again, I'm saying the control statements are used to take decisions according to certain conditions. So, okay, according to the given conditions, you want to take the decision, that is called as the control statements. So in the code, in our PHP code also, we can make decisions using this control statements. So there are certain control statements used in PHP. They are if else, else if, and switch statement. Okay. So this is switch case statement, and this is if else statement. Okay. If else, we'll first see about if else statement. This statement is used to execute one set of code when one of the condition is true and the other if the condition is false. Okay. So one set of statement is executed when the condition is true and the other set is executed when the condition is false. Okay. A syntax for the CX if else statement is syntax if the condition will be checked, the statements will be executed if the condition is true. Else the statements can, a false statement will be executed. Okay. So if the condition is true, the set of statements is executed. If the condition is not true, these set of statements are executed. Let us see one example. Okay. So let us see one example here. This is the program for if else. In this, we are having cost of some something. Okay. Cost of any product is 2000. If cost is greater than 2000, print the cost price is too high. Else, print the cost price is moderate. Okay. So, if the cost is greater than, it is too high. Else, print the cost is moderate. What will be the output for this? Children, can you guess what is the output for this? We are not getting any input from the user. You are assigning the value for the cost. Right, we are assigning 20,000 as the value for this cost variable. Okay, if you are getting in input, we cannot guess, but we are assigning the value. You can guess the result, right? What is the result? The cost price is moderate. Let us check. Yes, we can type a program. Yes, okay, so we'll type the program now. For that, what you want to see? You want to go to Notepad, right? Listen carefully. You want to go to the Notepad, open a new file. Before that, check whether you started your Apache server in the exam control panel. Before starting any program in PHP, you want to check whether these Apache and MySQL server is running or not. Okay. So this Apache and MySQL server, you should run. So it is running. Go to the Notepad. I'm going to type a program in PHP for if else statement. So we are going to assign the value for cost is equal to 20,000. Then if this cost is greater than 20,000, print the cost is too high. Yes, else print the cost is moderate, isn't it? So this is your program. You can close this. We can save it. Where you want to save? You want to save in your HT exam, in your C:\exam.htdocstudent. If you are having any folder, you can save it there. Otherwise, in htdocs itself, you want to save. Okay. So if conditional example, I am saving this, if conditional example dot php, and then I am going to run this program. How to run this program? Go to your browser, type http localhost. Yes, student is the folder name, and then if conditional example dot php. See, the cost is moderate. This is the result for the program we are having here, right? This is the result for the program we are having. So for this program, we got the result, right? Only this PHP statement have returned, not the HTML body part and all. Yes. So like this, you can refer all other example programs which is given in our book. Okay, we can go to the next statement. The next statement is else if statement. Else if statement are the statement used when one of the given condition is true. The if statement will check for a condition and true, a set of statements will be executed. And if false, again a condition is checked. If true, another set of, so here, what it is the main concept of this else if statement is, we are having two or three conditions, okay, nested if statement. It is called as nested if. The condition is true, it will go and execute some statement. If the condition is false, it will check the other condition, another condition, okay, likewise it goes on. If you see the syntax, it will be very clear. See, in the syntax, if the condition is true, the statements is executed. Else, if this condition is true, this statement. So we'll be having else if. So if this condition, if in this condition is false, it will go to this else part. There is one if condition. It will go, and if the condition is true, it will execute this. Else, it will go to the next statement. Okay. Like this, we can have many more else if statement. This is called as the nested if statement. For example program, we are having here, see, same program, if cost is 20,000, the cost equal to no, price is moderate, less than no, affordable, else the price is not affordable. Okay, let us see that once again in the program itself. See, if else if, okay, if the cost equal to 20,000, the cost is moderate, else if cost is 15,000. You can save this program and check it in our browser, http localhost, and here the cost is moderate only because we are having it is 20,000. Let us check with the cost with 13,000. Yes, we can check it with the cost with 13,000. Save this and then refresh this. See, the cost is affordable. So if this cost is below, it is not equal to 20,000, and if it is below 15,000, the cost is affordable. If these two conditions is not satisfied, it will go to the else part. Okay, so if the cost is below 15,000, the cost is affordable. If it is equal to 20,000, it is moderate. And if these two conditions are not satisfied, if the cost is above 20,000 or in between 15 to 20,000, the cost is not affordable. Okay. So like this only we'll be having the conditional statement. So if conditional statements also we check. We checked the if else conditional statement also. It is like the nested if statement. Here you are having an example. See, if condition true, body of the if. False, it is going to else if. If it is true, body of else if. Else false, it is going here, else if. So like this, we are having certain statements. Okay? Yes? Okay. So this is the basic conditional statements for every programming languages. Okay? So if conditional statement and else conditional statement programs. You are having any doubt in this if and else if? No, right? Yes? If you are having any doubt, if is only one condition checking. If condition, certain steps of statements will be executed, else other statements will be executed. This is the if condition statement. Okay. If condition, certain set of statements. See here, the syntax. If one condition statements executed, if the condition is true, else. So only one condition is checked here. So example, if only one condition, else this. In our else if, we are having the syntax as if the condition statement, and else if another condition also will be checked, the statements. Like this, we are having many else if here. So this is the example of your if and else if. All clear with this concept? Please go through this concept in the book also. Try to do some small programs which is given in the book. If you have any doubt, please ask me. This is the basic of all the programming language and the base for our PHP language also. Okay? Okay, the next video will be seeing the switch case statement. Got it?